Well, you recognise him, I know, but he's definitely on view today. The top scorer in the league, and it's live. What a perfect day for football we've got here. Martin Tyler here, along with Alan Smith. EFL League One football for you. It's coming up very shortly. Bolton Wanderers against Lincoln City.
Yeah, thanks, Martin. Looking forward to this. We've got some really good players out there, and importantly, we've got some match winners, some goal scorers down on that pitch. And I don't think we'll be disappointed.
Well, I know I'm looking forward to having a look at these two, Alan. Obviously, it's a team game, but they're intriguing individuals, aren't they?
They are, and they don't just play for themselves, which is the satisfying thing. They lift the head if there's a ball to be played, rather than shooting themselves. They will play that ball.
Have a look at the way Bolton Wanderers are going to play today with these players. Well, we think, Alan, it'll be a 4-5-1 formation, which can look a bit negative.
Yeah, but you look at the players in that five, that midfield five, and I think a couple at least will be trying to support the lone frontman.
Thank you.
Lincoln City will line up like this. One thing to look out for from this team today is the way they try and win the ball back within seconds of losing it.
Yeah, and they don't do it individually. They get backed up by a teammate. They hunt in packs, and you've got to do that. You've got to do it with discipline.
Well, this should be a great game, and we're off and running. Here's De Jong. A chance to play it into the centre now. Weir, a real chance. Pushed onto the frame of the goal. Kept his concentration, the goalkeeper, and because of that, kept hold of the ball.
Yeah, he seems to fill the goal, this lad. He's quite an imposing keeper.
Well, confirmation, as if it's needed, really. Everyone knows now, don't they, that the league title has been decided. The match will be played. But the big event of the day, Alan, is going to be the presentation.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, we've seen so many performances that got them to the
Well, that's what they've been looking for, the ball in behind. Can he shoot? And there it is!
The understanding you've got to admire here, Martin. The lad getting on to the end of it. The boy seeing the pass quickly.
Well, let's take another look at the goal. It's Bolton Wanderers who are in front then here. Interception here. It's good attacking play, this, from them. Really in the clear now, in on goal. It comes out off the goalkeeper.
Hear the roar going around the stadium, anxious that their team can really capitalise on this really good spell.
Well, they've worked the goalkeeper, but in truth, Alan, they haven't worked him very hard, have they?
Yeah, you're going to have to do a little bit better to beat this keeper.
And there's the interception. Crafting the through pass. Well, it's one of those that hits the post and goes in. Delight at the scorer.
He might have mishit it, I don't know, but he doesn't care.
It's Two for him on the day, and two very well taken goals. Well, they want to see this again, this goal. Restarting at 2-0. Well, back in possession of the ball.
The hosts have controlled possession here so far, and I've been really impressed by the way they've gone about the business, taken the game to the opposition. They've dictated the tempo. They're totally in control. Can they see it through to the end?
He could take them on here. Opportunity in a wider area. Got his foot in to cut out the pass. Chance to go at the opposition with pace. Trying to steer it through. Chippy! Racing upfield, leaving the opposition in their wake, really, and it deserved the finish that it didn't get.
No, 9/10 of it was good, but it's just that finishing touch that was lacking.
Careless there. Guided through. No doubt in the mind of the assistant, put his flag up straight away.
Yeah, it's a good call. I mean, lad's just got to bend his run a little bit. Well, he's not happy with his teammate on the ball. He expected a quicker pass. If he'd have had it, he'd have been onside.
It's O'Connor, Payne. They're looking good when they attack. Impressive in possession, passing's good, possibly dangerous. Was an opportunity to really put some pressure on the defenders, but the ball was a woeful one, too high. That's a great interception. Very confident, even in his own defensive third, to keep the ball. It's with De Jong. Probing pass. Can he finish it now?
The referee has indicated...
The ball's loose. Goalkeeper made the save, but he couldn't hold it. Now Grant. Walker. Bit of space to go forward into with the ball. Some players arriving in the middle now. And there goes the whistle for half-time. The scoreline is 2-0. I have to say, the game's passing him by in midfield today.
Well, if it continues like this, maybe the manager will substitute him. But he is a key player. His team are losing. They need to find a way to give him more touches.
And it is the kickoff here for the second half. Payne. It's O'Connor. Anderson. Didn't connect cleanly, and it's a shame, really, because it was a decent shooting position.
It certainly was, and if he gets another chance, he's got to do better. Hosts can't quite get hold of the ball, but they have played some slick, really beautiful football out there. the way that they broke out from defence, it's just been the pace of the play and the way that they've chosen the passes. It's been so clinical.
Attacking now. Have a turnover in play here with that interception. Intercepted well. His teammates have recognised the potential of this attack. That would be a throw. It is going to be a change here. And it looks like a strategic one. Weir. That is a tackle and a half. Here's Grant. It's O'Connor. Here's Walker. No need to stop the play there because they've got the ball and they can use the advantage. Here's De Jong. Left the defenders trailing now. Here's a chance.
It's opened up. Top performance from a top team, and they've emphasised their superiority with the number of goals that they've scored. This contest is over, done and dusted, but the post-mortem will be a long and arduous one.
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
Well, I know this manager's been working hard on the training ground on a certain shape, and boy, is it getting results out there.
One team really on their game today, the other very off colour. And 20 minutes to go. Oh, the attackers come in near post. Well, one pass away from being a great
this
move.
Is a message for Andy Topham.
Here's De Jong.
Andy Topham, can you please return to your vehicle immediately? Thank you.
Can really get at the opposition here. Must score! It's another one for them. They go further in front and they are full value for this position. A goal here to savour.
The defenders seem to lose the concentration almost. They saw it coming from a long way out.
And here is another angle on that goal.
Well, it's great when a plan comes together and the manager doubly delighted with the way his team are playing.
Well, it's not easy to find the spirit here that they're going to need in these circumstances as they kick off again. Here's Grant. He read the opponent's mind and got the ball. Payne. Difficult for the defender against the player who wants to take him on like this. There's going to be a substitution. It's for the away team. Chance for a break in numbers. Excellent movement to get the pass and stay onside. Can finish it off. Rebound into play off the... Most. Graham. Oh, it could be on. Well, they managed to dig themselves out of a pretty deep hole then. It was a great chance, I thought, but they're safe again. They're looking good when they attack. 3 minutes. That's all that's left now. Now O'Connor. Payne. 3 minutes, that's what's going to be played for added time. Another turnover in play here with that interception. Threading it through. They're coming in at the back post, his teammates. And we're going to get substitutions from both managers. Can they catch the opposition out with this short corner? And the referee brings it to a halt. Well, it turned out to be a different kind of game to the one perhaps we set up for you at the beginning. Very one-sided.
Yeah, you end up feeling a bit disappointed as a neutral because we didn't really get a contest, but the winning team won't be disappointed at all. Played well. Crafting the through pass. Well, it's one of those that hits the...
Some questions regarding the match. Thanks so much for your time.
Hello everyone, the weather forecasters promised us a very pleasant day for football, and that's exactly what we've got. I'm Derek Ray, with me for commentary is Lee Dixon, and all about action from League One coming right up. It's Ipswich Town, and they take on Bolton Wanderers.
Hi Derek, thank you. Well, both managers will be reminding their players how important it is to start off the game really quickly. Really attack the opposition, put them on the back foot, see what comes of that. Hopefully we get a good game.
Here's the Ipswich Town starting 11. A standard 4-4-2, a formation you know well from your playing days, Lee.
Yeah, I like this formation, Derek. It's very, very important that when they haven't got the ball, they all stick together. Very solid look about it. When they don't have the ball, very important that they stay close together in midfield. The back four will link across the width of the pitch, but they've got to help the forwards. The two up front need width.
And here's the starting lineup for Bolton Wanderers. Would you call it 4-5-1, Lee?
Yeah, I really like this formation, Derek. 4-2-3-1, really. The two central midfield players supplying support to a three ahead of them, and then a lone striker with a number 10 just behind him.
Thank you. Enjoy the game.
And the game begins. Norwood. Bishop. Crisp tackling. Hall. Keeping the ball moving. In position to give them the lead, maybe. A sloppy pass. Crossing possibilities. Happy to take on the shot. Well, it was straight at the keeper, but technically good goalkeeping. I believe there's been a goal in the Portsmouth game. Alan McAnally can tell us all about it.
It's a goal for Portsmouth. 10 minutes played. 1-0.
Many thanks, Alan. Well, confirmation as we look at the table of newly crowned champions. I say that, but today is the day when they'll receive that tremendous ball played through. And a wretched cross, really, over everyone. Good tackle. It'll be a throw. And now they have the ball back. Norwood. Ideal for the goalkeeper, for any keeper. Hall. Oh, a lovely ball. Can he take advantage? And it is the opening goal of the contest.
Well, it was always going to be a tight game, but now all of a sudden, one team ahead, things have got to change on both sides. Well, as we look at this again, the keeper's every right to ask where his back line was, but 2v1 in the end, he's thinking now, is he going to pass or go around me? He's got no chance.
The opening goal of the game, then.
Goal for Bolton Wanderers. Number 8, Luke Murphy.
I believe there's been a goal in the Peterborough match. Alan McAnally with the details.
It's a goal for Peterborough United. 26 minutes played, 1-1.
Thank you, Alan McAnally. Space and time for the cross. Now you've got to keep the ball a bit better than that. He's lost it. Can they switch to an even higher gear? And possession lost, intercepted. And now, passing it through. Well, clattered away. Now the delivery, punched away, and no-nonsense defensive clearance. And options in the centre. Jason Lowe with it. Element of risk there, but he's won the ball. Read it magnificently and intercepted. Well, that's a really good authoritative tackle. Throw in here. I'm being told there's been a goal at Fratton Park. Alan McAnally with the details.
It's a second goal for Portsmouth. 41 minutes played. 2-0.
Thanks, Alan. Murphy. Lowe. Can they do something positive on the counter-attack? He's got to score! And what a magical save it was!
2 minutes of added time.
And over comes the corner, punching it clear. Jackson. That is that for the first half here. Well, this man will get most of the plaudits for his contribution up to this point, Lee.
Well, Derek, you're right. He has played well, and goals win games. He's been a joy to watch in this form. Sit back and enjoy him in the second half.
As anticipated, plenty of talking points so far. And now the second half is underway. Given away. An important interception. Well, body in the way. Straight forward for the keeper. Low. Now they've lost it. Dangerous looking through ball. No real threat, you've got to say. Jason Low with it. Murphy. And attempting the through ball. Is this the moment? It must go in, surely. And it's gone in. The teams separated by 2 goals now. You cannot say they don't deserve it.
Well, here it is. How do you like them? In an open goal, please. No goalkeeper, no defenders. Where were they all?
It's going their way, 2-0. Norwood. And a goal has gone in at Fratton Park. To tell us more, Alan McInally.
It's a third goal for Portsmouth.
And he's made headway. It has to be. And he's made it a brace for himself. The defender's just unable to stay with him. And he's having a field day.
Well, let's see that one again. It's all about the contact. Does everything right. He's not bothered where the goal is. He knows where it is. He gets a beautiful strike on it.
Well, let's take another look at that goal, shall we?
Well, enjoy the good days as a coach. It can be a roller coaster ride, I can tell you that.
Well, they've been getting the substitute ready, and now they will make the personnel change. So they restart the game, and only one team in it.
With the owner of the
well, we had to interrupt Alan McInally just then. Apologies for that. Just to confirm, Portsmouth did score in that game. And they are running away with it, seemingly. 3-0 in front. And crossed in there. Insufficient accuracy with the header, Lee.
Yeah, he got there as well. It was all... about could he get it on target, but when you see how far he missed, wow.
I believe there's been a goal in the Peterborough match. Alan McInally with the details.
It's a second goal for Peterborough United. 67 minutes played.
Oh, a perfectly timed pass. Can he take advantage? Well, it's goal after goal after goal. Just no end to this. A brilliant display.
Well, it's a lovely goal. The pass was sublime, but then the finish. Not easy sometimes when you have so much time to think about it.
Well, let's go back to the goal that was scored. Underway again, this game very much over as a contest.
Number four, Jason Lowe.
Well, for understandable reasons, we had to cut off Alan McInally to confirm Peterborough have scored in that match. And they're in front at the moment by 2-1. Magnificent defending. And very deftly cut out. And it's a quality pass. Keeper's contribution, but what next? Smuggled away.
Substitution.
They've decided that now is the time to go to the bench.
Number 29, Luke Garbutt, to be replaced by number 20, Freddie Sears.
They will now make use of their substitutes bench. Crossing possibilities. He'll be delighted to have won the ball, having made that difficult challenge. Hole. There's a slide rule pass. Is it going to be? The goals keep going in for them. I don't think they're going to throw this away now. Absolutely omnipotent.
Well, Well, Derek, he sees the position of the goalkeeper and that's what makes his mind up for him. Beautiful chip.
Well, let's have another view of that goal.
Well, enjoy the good days as a coach. It could be a roller coaster ride, I can tell you that.
Well, it has been one-sided, but they deserve the plaudits for the fact that they've kept going and going. Only 10 minutes remaining here. Space on the flank. Might be a chance here. Well, it might still work out for them. Into the goalkeeper's grateful grasp, but the second time of asking, but first time around, it was a good deal more complicated.
Oh, it was a fabulous save initially. He gets the ball in the end with great relief.
Shot attempted. His third goal of the match, and you cannot argue with that.
Well, he's tearing this defence apart. They can't cope with him. Well, Derek, he can relax now. He's got the hat-trick, fully deserved. Well done indeed.
Well, the goal again, albeit from a different angle. It's a massive lead, and it's very hard to imagine them losing it now. Wilson, inside the final 2 minutes of this contest. An important interception.
The referee has indicated...
And the referee is going to add on four added minutes. Now, this might pay dividends. The goalkeeper, relatively untroubled.
Yeah, he's not going to let that one in, Derek.
Galindo giving it a try, and the goalkeeper will see that as part of doing his job. Well, he's given a corner, the referee. Elects to go short. And he did what he had to do defensively. And the referee blows for full time. And as we run the rule over this man's work, positive after positively.
Well, when you go home after a game, you always critique your own game performance. He's got nothing to criticise about that game today.
Can he take advantage? It is the opening goal of the contest.
Well, it was always going to be a tight game, but now all of a sudden, one team ahead, things have got to...
And attempting the through ball. Is this the moment? It must go in, surely.
Time for a few questions. Thanks.
Thank you, everyone, for coming. Thank you. Can we take your seats? And we'll start getting the questions in now. That's all we've got time for today. Thank you so much for coming, everyone.
It's a great day for football in this lovely stadium. Martin Tyler here, Alan Smith alongside me. It's EFL League One football, Bolton Wanderers against Gillingham.
Well, there's certainly a buzz in this stadium in the minutes leading up to kickoff. I hope the match doesn't disappoint. I don't think it will. We've got a couple of attacking sides here.
Well, this is where you want to come to see goals. The performance of the players for the home side this season, when they've been playing here at home, they're unstoppable.
Yeah, these home fans have been treated to some fantastic football and great goals.
Let's have a look at the way Bolton Wanderers are going to play today with these players. I think that back four is really important for them. They've got to be strong and solid, but they've got a bit of protection, haven't they?
They have. They should have more than enough. I mean, they're all good defenders in their own rights, but in front of them, they've got players who are going to be working really hard. Whether they can be a threat on the front foot, we'll wait and see.
Thank you. Enjoy the game.
This is the lineup for the away side. And again, we're going to see this shape up as a battle, individual battles, really, because the formations are so similar.
Yeah, they are similar. And you do see this so often these days, two really popular attacking shapes. So interesting how it pans out.
Weir. Easy in possession.
Weir,
that was the chance to go 1-0 up.
And to score this early on, that would have given him so much confidence. Well, frustration from the manager, but by the same token, his team are playing well. They might have gone ahead there, but they'll get another chance.
Galindo. It's with to guiding it through. He's had a go here. Well, they've gone for it right from the off, and they've got their reward with an early opening goal here.
Well, it looks simple, but this lad has got a great instinct of drifting into space, being in the right place at the right time.
Well, let's take another look at the goal. Bolton Wanderers with the lead. Fuller. Burns. Blocked off the pass there. Great if it had flown in, but in the end it didn't fly very close at all.
No, he looked a bit embarrassed after that effort.
Marshall, and here's Cisse. Fuller. Keeping the ball and looking for an opening. And Cisse really wanted to put his laces through it, but couldn't direct it.
Well, he had one or two options left and right there.
Weir. Galindo. Pass threaded through. It's come off the goalkeeper, still in play. Support coming from a deeper position. Probing away, working away at the opposition with these passes. Kept the ball, but he can't shoot at the moment. It's a good play to get a foot in and intercept. Burns. It's with De Jong. Galindo. Steered through. And finishing off. two in front now.
Well, keep the concentration and they've won this match, I think.
Well, scoring in any game is worthy of celebration. When you get two, it is special. And he is feeling that special delight at the moment. Let's see the replay now.
Well, I know this manager's been working hard on the training ground on a certain shape, and boy, is it getting results out there.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. Marshall. Teammates getting out of the way because they know he can dribble it here.
Good challenge.
The hosts have controlled possession here so far. And haven't we seen some lovely football out there? Knocked it about. It's been difficult for the opposition to get near to that ball at times. They've been given a real chasing.
That's well timed. Dangerous position. Marshall. Cissé. Marshall and Cissé. Return pass. Oh, great chance!
That hasn't troubled the keeper. Weir.
Guided through. He's a danger, isn't he? He'll run in behind. He's run offside this time, though.
Yeah, he's a nightmare for defenders. You can see them, they're a little bit twitchy, trying to keep him quiet.
It's with De Jong. Left the defenders trailing now. Here's a chance. Well, that should be the game. You could call it another insurance goal. Surely they can't throw it away here.
This contest is over, done and dusted. But the post-mortem will be a long and arduous one.
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
Well, it's great when a plan comes together and the manager doubly delighted with the way his team are playing.
You don't often see this, such a one-sided first half. They never really got going, the opposition, and they're surely out of the contest almost before it began. And the referee has signaled for half-time. 3-0 is the scoreline at this point. Just wonder whether the manager might have to change this to give him a bit more support in his area in midfield.
Well, that touch map, you see, it is really unusual for this player. He's normally very busy and has a lot more touches than this. And on a day when his team are losing, it's not ideal.
Well, we wonder if the second half's going to be like the first, one-sided. That's good passing, probing.
That is a good punch by the goalkeeper.
Galindo, excellent vision. Great chance.
Driven goalwards.
A sweet, sweet goal. Volleying in the cross.
That's all about timing, and he got it spot on there.
Terrific goal.
Well, coming in from the right, that was so inviting. Wonderful delivery.
Great ball, great goal. Let's have another peek at that goal.
Oh, he's loving it, the manager. He's seeing his team playing really well, just what he was asking for.
I don't think we expected this, such a one-sided affair, but look at the scoreline. And the away team want to make a change. Cissé. Able to make the interception. Striding forward, purposefully. He's got a chance to cross. Not really away from the threat here. It's with De Jong. And Cissé. Marshall. Well, here he goes. It's good to see a player do this. Weir. Well, they're getting the ball forward. They need to do that. Really wanted to put his laces through it, but couldn't direct it.
Well, he had one or two options left and right there.
Well, Alan, here's the substitution now.
Well, he's done his bit. He got the goal that put his team in the lead. Can they hold that lead?
Now, can he take them on? And he could get away here.
I'm sure the manager will be delighted with this. Fantastic teamwork, lovely ball through.
Well, it's a goal worth replaying over and over again, isn't it? So they restart again, a bit demoralised now, I think, in a game like this.
Just to let you know,
20 minutes of the 90 still to play.
If you'd like to get your tickets for the next game or club merchandise.
Trying to slip it through. Can he finish it now? Two for him today, and his team are benefiting from his sharpness in front of goal, knocking the ball into the back of the net. So slick, so quick, Alan.
Well, once he got going, those defenders were never going to catch him. What a finish, too.
Let's see the replay now. Well, the body language at this kickoff isn't great, is it? And you can understand why. Just over a quarter of an hour left on my watch. He's cut it out. Shredding it through. Hearts out of danger there with that clearance. Substitution now for the home team. Here's De Jong. Now they're looking to get forward from this position. Cleared it well. Weir. It's with De Jong. Oh, an important interception that. Marshall. He's got skill with the ball, backing himself in these circumstances. And out wide, they were in a good position until that defender acted very promptly and decisively. It's with De Jong.
The referee has indicated...
Tries the shot here. It was a real opportunity, but there might be a key moment in there from a defensive point of view.
Yeah, well, they really did converge on him quickly. He didn't miss by much, but he's missed it.
And it's Cissé. And it's come to an end now as the referee calls a halt. Alan, I don't think the opposition were really on their game at all, but we shouldn't take anything away from the winners.
No, I think when you look at the way they knocked the ball about, they used the full width of the pitch, it was a thoroughly entertaining performance.
Galindo, steered through,
can finish it off. Two in front now.
Well, keep the concentration and they've won this match, I think.
Left the defenders trailing now, here's a chance. Well, that should be the game. You could call it another insurance goal. Surely they can't throw it away here. Chance! Driven goalwards. A sweet, sweet goal, volleying in the cross.
That's all about timing, and he got it spot on there.
Now, can he take them on?
Hi, sorry, can we just grab a moment of your time? Thanks for speaking to us.
You